हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, लेक्चर 37। इन दिस वीडियो लेक्चर वील डिस्कस अबाउट समरी ऑफ सिविक्स चैप्टर 1, दैट इज पावर शेयरिंग। इन केस ऑफ पावर शेयरिंग फर्स्ट वील डिस्कस टू केसेस ऑफ पावर शेयरिंग, दैट इज पावर शेयरिंग इन श्रीलंका एंड पावर शेयरिंग इन बेल्जियम। सो फर्स्ट वील डिस्कस Srilanka, that in what way power was shared in Sri Lanka or was not shared. Sri Lanka is basically divided into two linguistic groups, that is Sinhala speakers and Tamil speakers. Sinhala speakers are 74% and they are Buddhist, whereas Tamils are 18% and Tamils are Hindus and Muslims and Christian as well. But out of them, out of these 18%, 13% Tamils are native Tamils of Sri Lanka, and 5% are Indian Tamils, and remaining 8% are Christians. Christians are both Sinhalas as well as Tamils. Now, Sri Lanka emerged as independent country in 1948. A democratically elected government adopted a series of majoritarianism, that is Sinhala supremacy. They declared Sinhala as the supreme religion or the language, Buddhist. Then in 1956, an act was passed to make Sinhala the official language, and also Buddhism was declared state religion, and no consideration was given to Tamil language and their religion. Against this, the Tamils in Sri Lanka reacted. Then they started forming many political parties. Then Sri Lankan Tamils launched other agitations against this, and ultimately, when their demands were not met, then they came into, or they put Sri Lanka into a civil war. So this was the outcome of no power sharing in Sri Lanka, and this civil war put Sri Lankan government in high instability. Now, opposite to this, Belgium is a small country in Europe, smaller than Haryana in population as well as area. Then the ethnic composition of Belgium is also very different, that is 59% of the country's population live in Flemish regions and speak Dutch language. 40% people live in Wallonia and they speak French, and remaining 1% people speak German. They live in both the regions. Whereas the Belgian capital Brussels has a different linguistic composition, that is 80% people of in capital city Brussels are French and 20% are Dutch speaking. This is just opposite to that of a country. Now, in Belgium also, the power sharing mechanism was questioned, and these Dutch speaking and French speaking raised questions over, and conflict arise between these two communities. So from 1970 to 1993, Belgian constitution was amended 4 times, and the following changes were made. Number 1, the constitution prescribed that number of Dutch and French speaking shall enjoy equal representation in central government. Number 2, state governments are not subordinate to central government. Brussels, the capital city, has a separate government in which both the communities enjoy equal representation. A third kind of government, that is community government, was formed, which has powers in culture, educational matters and language related issues. This is how the power sharing mechanism became a model, role model for the European Union, and when European Union was formed, Brussels, the capital city of Belgium, was chosen its headquarter. Now, one more small case study of power sharing, that is Lebanon. So, Lebanon's conflict, Lebanon is basically a Middle East country. Lebanon is a Middle East country, and it is also fell into civil war. So, Lebanon is basically having two religious communities, that is Muslims and Christians. So, during the civil war, when civil war was going on in Lebanon for power sharing, the ministers of both the communities, leaders of both the communities sit together, and they had drawn some power sharing model. And as per that power sharing model, the president would be elected from Maronite section of Catholic Christians. Prime Minister will be from the Sunni Muslims of, that is the Sunni Muslim community. The Sunni Muslim community is divided into two sections, that is Shia and Sunni. So Prime Minister was decided to be elected from Sunni Muslim community, and Deputy Prime Minister would be from Orthodox Christian section, and Speaker would be from the Shia Muslim community. And as per this agreement, the Christian agreed not to seek any protection, and Muslims agreed not to seek any kind of unification with neighboring state of Syria, and the conflict came to settle down. After that, it comes the desire of power sharing. Power sharing is desired for two reasons, that is prudential reasons and moral reasons. Prudential reasons are to the effect of the loss in profit of the country. Prudential reasons that avoids the possibility of social conflict between two or more social groups. And power sharing is a good way to ensure the stability of political order through unity of the country. Then moral reasons. Moral reasons uphold the power sharing as the very spirit of democracy. A democratic country involves sharing power with those who are affected by its existence, and people have the right to be consulted and equal participation in the government. So this is how power sharing is desired. Now, various forms of power sharing. Next article is various forms of power sharing. In this, first comes the power sharing among organs of the government. A democratically elected government generally has three organs, that is legislature, executives, and judiciary. Legislature makes the laws, executives implement those laws, and judiciary ensures that those laws are abided by, those laws are followed as per the instructions issued. And all the three organs enjoy equal powers, but they are not subordinate. No organ is superior or no organ is inferior, but they keep a check on each other that no organ is using any power unlimited. So that's why this system is also called a system of check and balance, or the horizontal power sharing. Second form of power sharing is power sharing among different levels of government. Democratically elected government generally have two or three levels of government. In case of India and Belgium, we have seen that India has three levels of government, that is union government, central government for the entire country, which legislate all rules, regulations which are of the interest of the country. State governments, which look after the day-to-day administration of the state, and they make laws pertaining to state people. And local self-government includes the panchayats of villages, and up to Jila Parishad it goes. So the root level democracy, this is called root level democracy. So power shared, that is central government gives power to state government. It never means that state governments are subordinate. State governments are not subordinate to सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट, स्टेट गवर्नमेंट्स आर इंडिपेंडेंट इन टर्म्स ऑफ लेजिस्लेशन, एग्जीक्यूशन एंड एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन. सिमिलरली सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट एंड स्टेट गवर्नमेंट डिस्ट्रीब्यूट देयर पावर्स टू द पंचायती राज एंड स्टेट गवर्नमेंट्स हैव देयर ड्यूटी टू सुपरवाइज द लोकल सेल्फ गवर्नमेंट इन एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन एंड देयर वर्किंग. सो दिस वे दिस सिस्टम इज कॉल्ड वर्टिकल पावर शेयरिंग. वर्टिकल फ्रॉम टॉप सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट, देन स्टेट गवर्नमेंट, देन लोकल सेल्फ गवर्नमेंट. इट इज कॉल्ड वर्टिकल पावर शेयरिंग. नेक्स्ट इज पावर शेयरिंग अमंग डिफरेंट सोशल ग्रुप्स. सोशल ग्रुप केस वी हैव डिस्कस्ड इन बेल्जियम दैट डच स्पीकिंग, फ्रेंच स्पीकिंग, जर्मन स्पीकिंग, दे ऑल शेयर इक्वल रिप्रेजेंटेशन इन सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट, इन स्टेट गवर्नमेंट, इन कैपिटल सिटी ब्रसल्स गवर्नमेंट और द कम्युनिटी गवर्नमेंट. इन इंडिया ऑल्सो डिफरेंट कम्युनिटीज, डिफरेंट सोशल ग्रुप्स, दैट इज एस सी, एस टी, ओ बी सी, दे इंजॉय सम रिजर्वेशन बेस्ड ऑन प्रोपोर्शन ऑफ देयर पॉपुलेशन. Women also, that on the social groups based on gender, women also enjoy some reservation in panchayati raj. So this is what are the examples of power sharing among social groups. Next is the power sharing among political parties, pressure groups and business groups. Since 1990 or the 1990s onwards, there is a new system of democracy developed. That is coalition or the alliance government. Before 1990, generally a single political party used to get clear majority, so there was no issue about coalition. But after 1990s, a multi-party system developed in Indian democracy, which led to coalition and alliance. Since no one party got clear majority, and then making government, two or more parties come together to make alliance and they form government. This was the example of power sharing by different political parties. Pressure groups and movement groups. We have just nowadays we are seeing the farmers' agitation is going on. Now the farmers' agitation is a kind of pressure group. They are pressurizing the government to take those farm acts back. Here we will not discuss much about those acts, but now farmer group is a pressure group, an example of pressure group. In past also we have seen many pressure group, that is Anna Hazare movement group. So that also pressurized the government to form, that is Lokpal Bill, etc., are some examples of pressure groups. Business groups also put pressure on government, so that when government, the political party to which they are funding, to which they are giving money as a donation, so at that time they may bring some policies which may help their trade internationally or nationally. So this is how power is shared among different political parties, pressure groups, movement groups and business groups. So that's all from this chapter, and important questions you will follow in the downside column of the video. So thank you very much. Keep on watching. In next video, you will see civics chapter 2, that is federalism.